Sports Card Podcast, where we tackle the hobby's hottest topics in depth to help you navigate the sports card landscape and enjoy the hobby we all love. Here's your host, John Newman.
All right, time for another episode of Hobby Quick Hits. Today's show, saving money to put towards your hobby. It's going to be a look at some things I've learned, some internally, some from other people, that's allowed me to put more money into hobby things. Some things will be hobby money-saving tips. Some things will be external. But either way, if you love the hobby and you like buying things and opening things, it's a way to save more money to put towards your hobby spending budget. But before we get the episode started, it wouldn't be possible without the guys from Mojo Break doing big things locally in California, but across the globe as well. And they're the sponsors of the show. Let's hear from them. And after that, we'll get this thing underway. Hey folks, wanted to tell you about the best place to get some of your sealed sports card wax products. Great selection and some of the lowest prices on the web. MojoBreakShop.com is that place. Whether it's a box or a whole case, they're your guys, and they ship around the world right to your door. The Mojo Break name is one of the most trusted in the hobby. From sports cards to Pokemon, their selection can't be beat. They offer daily deals and pre-orders. Who won first place at this year's Topps Rip Party? None other than Mojo Break. Their prices are already great, but here's a way to save even more money. Use the code QUICKHITS, that's QUICKHITS, for 10% off anything on MojoBreakShop.com. They also have a full-service card shop in Santa Clara, California. So if you're in the area, stop by. They're open 7 days a week, so check them out at MojoBreakShop.com. All right, so let me tell you about the dollar envelope. And I can't take credit for the dollar envelope, although I've taught it to other people who I know are doing it. It was taught to me by one of my best friends. His name is Chad. He's also the godfather of my son, Jordan, and something he's done for a long time. He's a school teacher, but he actually did this before he got his master's and became a school teacher. And he was going to Vegas like twice a year. He's not a big gambler, but he'd go, have fun, you know, maybe do a little gambling, but just enjoy the trip. I never went. I've never been to Vegas. And at the time, like I said, he wasn't a school teacher. He had an okay job at the time. But, you know, I asked him. I said, Chad, I got to be nosy, man. You know, we're really good friends. So I can get away asking. How are you pulling off these Vegas trips twice a year? He goes, well, number one, the airfare's cheap. I luck out there, which at the time, I believe, was like $99, you know, to get there. But he goes, the other thing I do is my dollar envelope. And I said, dollar envelope? What's your dollar envelope? And he goes, well, every day when I come home for the day and I'm not going back out, whatever singles, whatever ones I have in my pocket, I put it in an envelope. And I do that every day. And at the end of the year, it's, you know, I turn that in. And he goes, it works out, I usually have about $700, $800, $900. And then I use that money the next year. You know, you save it up all year, and I use it the next year to do those things you asked me how you afford that. And it pays for the bulk of it. You should do it, John. You don't even notice it. You come home when you're done for the day, just throw your ones that you have cash in the envelope and forget about it. And then when you get 50 of them, you know, you put the $50 wrapper, you get it from your bank, and you put it in your safe or wherever you want to keep it. And then at the end of the year, you turn all those bundles of $50 in there. And I said, man, does that really work? Are you going to be able to save that much? I thought, you know, I knew he wasn't lying, but at the same time, I'm like, seems like a lot of money just from saving ones up every day. But I said, you know what? I'm going to do it. And the first year I did it, which was about 9 years ago now, maybe a little bit longer, but around 9 years ago, The first year I did it, I got $700 at the end of the year without even noticing. It was almost like a bonus check. I said, man, that is cool. And I've done it every year since. And so my highest year's been, I think, 9-something. And even the lowest year has been like about $600 or $575. And so it's I don't want to say it's free money. It is your money. No one's giving it to you. But you don't notice it. And at the end of the year, when you got all those $50 bundles and you go to your bank to turn them in and get the bigger bills or deposit it or however you want to distribute it, it's nice. It's almost unexpected. And so the other thing I also do besides that is I have a big bank. And as the same thing I do with the ones, right? I come home and I'm not going back out. Put the ones in the dollar envelope. And any change I got goes into that. It's like actually a Corona bottle bank. You know, it's a big plastic Corona bottle. And what I do is at the end of the year, I turn in my ones from the dollar envelope, bundled in 50s, and all that change. And between the combination of two, I'm going to be honest with you, I'm almost always at least over $1,000. And so what do I do with that $1,000, right? Well, what if since I've, you know, really come back into the hobby, you know, strong, I put it, you know, in the 2019 National in Chicago. I use that money to go to Chicago. I'm going to use last year's money to go to Chicago this year again. It pays for my room, board, and, you know, it pays for my room, some food, and my airfare. And obviously, I have money from other sources for to fill in all the other blanks. But it pays a good chunk of my travel, my hobby travel, food, and, you know, flight and hotel for a couple trips I make, what are probably going to be the couple trips I make now on an every year basis. And that will be, I really want to take 2 to 3 trips a year hobby related wise, meaning one's probably going to always be the National and the other will be either a regional show like I did in Dallas or the industry summit in Las Vegas this year. So this year, I want to try to pull off the trifecta. Already done the Dallas show. All my itinerary is all set for Chicago, and I'd still like to do the industry summit. And these money and coin envelopes, or the dollar envelope and the coin bank, funds you know, at least one of those almost entirely, and that helps to be able to do another one with other ways to do it. So some other ways that I save some money that can go towards the hobby is, you know, another thing I do, if you're into stocks and bonds, this is something I do, is you get dividend, deposits. So, hey, this stock performed well. It's sort of a quarterly every 3 months. And obviously, the more stocks you own, you get more of these dividend deposits. Some people opt to get the actual checks, especially if you own a lot of like one company shares. I try to diversify. So my deposits are, you know, anywhere, can be as low. My dividend can be as anywhere as low as 75 cents to $38. But I get, you know, a decent amount of them because of the different stocks I own. And so what I also do is that it goes into a sweep account. And where some people put that right back into more stocks, I will use that money. I will take that out also once a year and put it towards travel and hobby expenses and those sort of things. I think one year, a couple years ago, I think I bought a case of Inception from Topps with just my dividend monies from the stocks, just the dividends. Okay, so again, that's because I have stocks. Not everyone, someone's going to listen to this and say, "Well, that's great for you, John." I don't play the stock. I'm not in the stock market. So if you are, something to think about, how I handle that you know, dividend side of things. Another thing you could do, I don't do this myself, but I know someone who does. They told me about it. And what that is this. He told me that whenever he makes a hobby purchase, he adds 10% and puts that as if he's spending it to purchase whatever, but he puts it away and it was safe or wherever. He didn't really specify where he put it. And then again, at the end of the year, he has that money. So, for example, the way he explained it, if he buys a card for $100, he actually buys, he puts $10 in addition to that. That's the 10%, $110. And he actually puts that $10 aside. And it's just a way to save money. And again, at the end of the year, if he spent $5,000 in the hobby, right, he's also now got $500 in an envelope or wherever he's put that money aside to go into next year's budget, right? He has $500 more to spend. And he explained it to me. If he can't afford that, you know, 10% is going to make the difference between making that purchase or not, he doesn't make the purchase, you know. So if he buys, you know, a box of Top Series 1 for $150, it's going to be $165 at 10%, $15. So, and he puts that aside, and at the end of the year, he's got a nice chunk of change there, most likely, depending on what he spent. He calls it a hobby tax. He actually coined it, hobby tax. I've heard some other people, this was a conversation I directly had, but I've seen other people post they do similar or same things. They might change their percentage. You know, he does 10%. I think I saw someone post they do the same thing, but it's 5%. I saw someone else who said they spend a lot of money in the hobby, and so they use 1%. Whatever, you know, whatever works for you. You know, my dollar envelope is like that, except it's just something I do every day, regardless of purchase. Those dividend sweeps, those coins, that's just something. Whatever works for you. Also, if you're listening to this episode and you do something, you have an idea, or you do something different, please let me know, because I can do sort of a part two with how to save money for the hobby, right? Some other people who do more transacting in the hobby, who really keep charts, hey, I paid this for this, and then they know what they sell it for, they may take 10%, you know, of their profit, their ROI, and put it into like a savings account to be accessed next year for additional purposes. So there's a different way to save. You know, some people have a swear jab, swear jar. Whatever works. I just wanted to share some of the things I do. There's other things you can do. You know, just like a Christmas club. You know, you could, rather than me who just takes whatever's in your pocket at the end of the day, you can designate $10 a week, let's say. $10 a week at the end of the year is going to be $520. It's like a hobby savings account, right? You can do that. Hobby Christmas club. Whatever you do. You know, some people get a quarterly bonus or a monthly bonus at their job from their employer. They put that towards their hobby spending. Which, you know, unless if you get it from sort of outside sources or it doesn't hurt you all in one sum, you take less from your normal account, right? Now, for me, I have a separate business account. I have a Newman Sports Cards account. So any of my sports card purchases do not come out of my joint account with my wife. Not a penny. She honestly doesn't know what I spend on the hobby or what I make, and I gotta, you know, she knows I do well or whatever, you know. She never really asks. She doesn't want for too much either. I don't want to make it sound like, you know, I got an offshore Switzerland bank account and I'm planning my escape, nothing like that. But she's, you know, I was doing this before I met her, and I've never really stopped, and she knows it's something I enjoy, and She doesn't pry too much. Sometimes I will share that information with her, and every once in a while she might ask, like, how's it going? I hear it's, you know, I saw it in the news. I mean, this year especially, cards are blowing up. And if I make a real big sale, which happens some, you know, some, and I'm talking four or more digits, I will tell her that. And, you know, we're usually, you know, eating steak or lobster that week to be blunt on us. So, you know, but that's really a separate thing for me. Some people don't have that luxury, if you will. That, in other words, they just have one account with their spouse or significant other. And so what they spend in the hobbies may be more scrutinized. Maybe you're more scrutinized than, frankly, I am. So the way, if you can save, you know, money to put towards your hobby where it doesn't have to come out of that account and be as noticeable or get you in trouble potentially, you know, it should look at ways to do it. So if you have a different way that I didn't mention or a different idea, I'd love to hear what you do to save money to put towards your hobby. So I hope you took something from this episode, whether it's you starting a dollar envelope or a coin, you know, a change bank for end of the year collection and then turn in at the end of the year. If you do start a dollar envelope because I kind of explained that to you and you liked it and you wanted to start it, please, I'm really interested to see updates, how you're doing and you know, what you get at the end of the year. Even if you start it now, you still got about, you know, half the year. So give me updates to how that dollar envelope's doing for you. I love it, and it's something, again, I've done it for 9 years, and I'll do it, you know, as for the unforeseen future from now on. So, but if you have another money-saving tip, let us know, and maybe we'll do a part two of the show if I get enough of those. With that being said, hope everyone is doing well. We'll see you next time on another edition of Hobby Quick Hits. Hey folks, thanks for listening to the show. Wanted to give out our social media links where you can follow the show even when you're not listening to it. On Twitter, we are @HitsHobby, HitsHobby. On Instagram, we are @HobbyQuickHitsPodcast, all one word. Our website is www.sportscardnation.net. Look for the link to Hobby Quick Hits. You'll find us there. And you can always text us on our text line, area code 315-491-0239.
So long, farewell, I'll be to say adieu.
Adieu, adieu, to you and you and you.